First of all, what would you tell your 31, if you met yourself 31 years ago, what would you tell yourself about agriculture?
I would tell myself to look upon it seriously, not to despise it, because it's a direct method of improving your livelihood. For all the young guys out there, really farming is something they should look at. It's not, and we have had a live demonstration today. You can see this is Mr. Kapshinga is a very busy man, very busy in Kampala, but he has time, makes time to come out here and do some serious fun. And I think he's the best kind of example for all those young guys there.
Now, most of us have our brothers in the villages. Mm. Some of us were born in the city, but what we think about is we always encourage our brothers in the villages to sell pieces of land and come to the city, buy a boda boda, or maybe get a job as a taxi conductor to try, maybe be a barber in town. What would you tell a person who's thinking about migrating from the village to the city?
Rural-urban migration is it's part of the natural process of societies developing. But I would urge people to think about it carefully, because you might end up abandoning your farm, your small piece of land, which is more valuable than the border that you're going to ride around for a few months. Probably get an accident or have to maintain it, and you do not have the means to maintain it. So this craze or this attraction for the town can be dangerous. If you're going to town, have a plan for how you're going to survive in that town. As you know, the cost of living in town is much higher than in the rural area. So you may be losing a lot of opportunities that you by rushing to the town.
I overheard Mr. Robert Kapshinga saying that you're doing something of your own, in agriculture. The reason why we young people leave the villages to come to the city is because when I start a phone business, I buy a phone, I sell it, quick money. I don't need to wait for 3-4 months. What is that one crop that you would, say to me that, for a young person, 25, 28, because they're in love with quick money, maybe there's something that is quick in farming that, such people can engage in?
Well, I have learned a lot today here. You could see, you heard about bananas. I think he said that he sells every month, twice?
Twice a month.
Twice a month.
Yeah.
All the figures he was giving us there. Coffee may take a longer time. Beehives, maybe fishing, all these things may not take as long as people may think they may take, and you may actually benefit more. Personally, I'm a cattle farmer, so that takes a bit more time, but the rewards are there. There's real monetary gain, even in that area.
So, if I just get personal a bit, how many cattle do you?
No,
it's like. I'm sorry, it's a personal question.
Somebody asked, and they said you shouldn't ask about.
Bank account.
Ask about bank accounts. I would not say I'm a big farmer at all, cattle farmer. I'm starting off, but I have a few cows.
Now, I have, you know, a few chicken that I try to take care of here and there. And I said, I know we agreed we're not going to talk about other things apart from, you know, farming here. But if I wanted to sell something to the army, how hard or how easy would it be?
The army has suppliers. Actually, the army is one of the biggest markets out there. The army has suppliers. I think each division has vetted suppliers to supply them. So there's a process. You have to apply, and then I think they look at your capacity to provide a certain either whether it's kaunga or fish or beef. There's a process you go through. Once you have been shortlisted, once you have gone through that vetting process, then you supply the army, and lots of people out there supply the army.
Now, thank you very much for your time. Just one last thing. Most of the people who are going to be watching this are on social media, on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. That's where they are. That's where we spend most of our time. What message would you leave them for 2019?
Well, two things. Let's try and be more productive economically. Let's be more patriotic as young people. And three, look after yourselves. Yeah, look after your health.
Well, I couldn't say it more. Look after yourself, be patriotic, and let's be productive. It's 2019. I mean, what else do you need? Thank you very much for your time. Back to you in studio.